Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. If you have not already done so, we suggest that you view the first video in this series before watching this one. Let's say that we and some of our friends own this petting farm. It costs money to feed the animals, so to raise more money, you want to sell more admission tickets using our website. This is the homepage of our current website. One of our partners thinks that we will sell more tickets if we change the color of the Buy Tickets button so it's not white. Another one of our partners thinks the button color will not affect ticket sales and that we should leave it alone. We decide to use the scientific method to answer this question. We can remember the four basic steps of the scientific method because together they spell the word data. We can then expand each word into the first part of a sentence to see the full scientific method. Although we won't publish our research as part of the last steps of the scientific method, we can use this method to help answer a business question, as is often done in webpage A/B testing, as we will demonstrate in this video. The first step in the scientific method is to decide on the question to research. We decide to use this question because it is a yes or no question. Does the color of the Buy Tickets button affect the number of tickets sold? The second step in the scientific method is to arrange the research question as a hypothesis. A hypothesis is the guessed answer of the research question. When we are first learning about the scientific method, it can help to use the word depends in the hypothesis, so that later we can identify the variable types and graph the results. The number of tickets sold depends on the color of the Buy Tickets button. This hypothesis might be false, but that's okay. Our experiment will tell us if the hypothesis is true or false. The main thing is to have a hypothesis that we can test as being true or false. Now we're ready to do the third step of the scientific method, which is to test the hypothesis with an experiment. Our partners made some other homepages for the experiment. Which of these should we use for the comparison with our current homepage? The reason we picked option B is because it is exactly the same as the current homepage, except for the button color. Rather than using letters or long descriptions to refer to our webpage options, we will call the current homepage the control page, and the homepage we're testing we will call the experimental page. The one difference between these two pages is the button color, which is the independent variable in this experiment. We set the value of the independent variable. The value of the independent variable is white for the control page, and it is yellow for the experimental page. Our website designer tells us that she can change what homepage internet visitors see when they visit the website, and asks us when we want each webpage to be shown. She gives us these choices. Choice A, control page in the first half of the day. Experimental page in the second half of the day. Choice B, experimental page in the first half of the day and control page in the second half of the day. Choice C, control page and experimental page alternating every day. That means they take turns being shown as the home page as people visit the website. Here are the three options on one screen. Which option should we use for our experiment? The reason we pick option C is because a good comparison uses the same times for the things being compared. For example, what if more people buy tickets in the evening when their families are home from work and school? If that was the case, then whatever web page is shown in the evenings will get more sales and have an unfair advantage over the other page that is not shown in the evenings. To avoid giving one web page an unfair advantage, we will show both web pages at all hours of the day. For the experiments that we design in primary school, we want the two groups to be the same except for the one thing that we are interested in researching. The things that are the same between the groups are called control variables. The one thing that is different among the groups is called the independent variable. In this study, the control variables are the things that are the same between the control and experimental homepages. This includes how the rest of the web pages look and the times that the web pages will be displayed. For the next week, we run the experiment. During this time, we count up the tickets being sold when the control page versus the experimental page is used as the home page. The tickets sold is the dependent variable in this experiment. Unlike the independent variable, we do not set the dependent variable, but rather we measure it. Since we designed this experiment such that the control homepage and experimental homepages are shown on the same days and times, and since those pages are identical in appearance except for the color of the buttons, then if there is a difference in the number of tickets sold, we can conclude that difference is due to the color of their buttons. A week later, our website designer tells us we sold 105 tickets using the control page and 315 tickets using the experimental page. Now that we've finished with the experiment, it's time to analyze the results. In high school and beyond, we'll use a branch of math called probabilities and statistics to analyze our data, but for now we'll display the data as a graph. Should we use a bar graph or a line graph? We cannot use a line graph because a line graph is made of two number lines, which means each page would need to have two numbers. But we only have one number for each page, which is the number of sales for that page. Color is not a number, so we cannot use a line graph. So, we'll use a bar graph to graph these results. On state exams, we may be given a choice like this and asked to plot the results. We click on the top edge of the boxes, then lift them to the values shown. This is an example of using the scientific method to solve a business question so the business can be more successful. For the rest of this video, we'll review variable definitions. These are often confusing when we are new to research, but we have to know the correct names so that we can do more advanced research, and also because these are likely to be test questions. Which variable's value do we set? We set the value of the independent variable. In this case, it was white or yellow. The dependent variable is the one we measure. In this case, it was the number of tickets sold. The controlled variables are everything else. These should be the same between the control and the experimental groups. The hypothesis contains the word depends. We use depends in the hypothesis so that we can tell what the dependent variable is. The dependent variable is always the one before the word depends. The dependent one depends on the independent one. One way to remember this is to think of a lamb and its mother. If you make a sentence with the words lamb, mother, and depends, then you will remember that the dependent variable comes first. That is also the case when we make a hypothesis with the word depends. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.